इनकम एंड कंजम्पशन द मॉनेटरी एक्सपेंडिचर पर कैपिटा नीडेड फॉर बाइंग द रिक्विजाइट कैलोरी रिक्वायरमेंट्स इन टर्म्स ऑफ फूड ग्रेन्स एट्सेट्रा इज कैलकुलेटेड इट इज रिवाइज पीरियडिकली टेकिंग इन टू कंसिडरेशन द राइज इन प्राइजेज ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दीज कैलकुलेशंस फॉर द ईयर 2011-12 द पॉवर्टी लाइन फॉर अ पर्सन वॉज फिक्स्ड एट रुपीज 972 पर मंथ फॉर द रूरल एरियाज and rupees 1000 for the urban areas. Again, you can see the difference. Why it is difference? Because the requirements, the necessity in the cities are the costlier than the villages. Vulnerable groups kya hai hamare? Scheduled tribes, scheduled caste means ST, SC, agriculture laborers and casual laborers are the most vulnerable groups in India. Interstate disparities. The proportion of poor people is not the same in every state. Bihar and Orisha are the poorest state in India. Poverty decline in state region. So let's read about this also. Poverty decline in state region. What are these? First, Punjab and Haryana, due to high agricultural growth rates, Kerala, owing to more focus on human resources development. Third one is West Bengal land reforms. And fourth is Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu public distribution of food grains. Right? So in these areas, poverty is declined. And reasons I have given you above. National Sample Survey Organization means NSSO. This organization estimates the poverty line periodically, normally every 5 years, by conducting sample surveys. Global poverty scenario. According to the World Bank definition, a person living on less than $1.90 per day is poor. According to the most recent estimates in 2013, 10.7% of the world's population lived on less than $1.90 a day. The Sustainable Development Goals of the United Nations calls for ending the extreme poverty by 2030. Fine. So let's see what are the causes of poverty. These are policies of the British era. We are just following same policies till now. So now there we can see the changes, but because of this, India was suffering with the poverty. So first is policies of the British era. Low economic growth after independence up to 80s. Third one is population growth. We can see a extreme change in the population. We are the second highest country of the world in terms of population. Fourth one is limited success of green revolution. Then next, unequal distribution of land and other resources. And the last one, the sixth point is socio-cultural factors. So anti-poverty measures, basically this we can measure on two strategies. These are promotion of economic growth and targeted anti-poverty programs. So promotion of economic growth, basically it is a strong link between economic growth and poverty reduction. Economic growth widens opportunities and provides the resources needs to invest in human development. However, the poor may not be able to take advantage from the opportunities created by economic growth. Growth also increases the government revenues and consequently it could afford the program for poverty reduction. Next was the targeted anti-poverty programs that Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act 2005, Prime Minister Rozgar Yojana, Swarn Jayanti Gram Sav Rozgar Yojana, Pradhan Mantri Gramodyog Yojana and Antyodaya Anna Yojana. So growth also increases the government revenues and consequently it could afford the programs for poverty reduction. दैट इज़ वाई दीज टू स्ट्रैटेजीज आर ऑल्सो नॉन एज कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री टू ईच अदर. फाइन. सो आवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ एंड पॉवर्टी रिडक्शन इंटरकनेक्शन. द इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ अप टू द अर्ली 80s, 1980s एंड 1990s एंड द लेवल ऑफ पॉवर्टी इज अ डायरेक्ट एविडेंस ऑफ कनेक्शन बिटवीन इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ एंड पॉवर्टी रिडक्शन. दैट द क्वेश्चन अराइजेज हाउ द ग्रोथ हेल्प्स इन द रिडक्शन ऑफ पॉवर्टी. कंसेप्चुअली रैपिड इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ वर्क्स थ्रू टू चैनल्स. वन इज इट क्रिएट्स वेल पेड जॉब्स एंड रेजेज रियल वेजेस. बोथ फैक्टर रेज इनकम ऑफ पुअर हाउस होल्ड्स देयर बाय directly reducing the poverty. Further, with increased income, the households are able to spend in education and health services. This spending in education and health helps in the reduction of poverty in the long run. More income leads to more investment in business and industries, thereby creating more employment and consequently reduction in poverty. Second point is rapid economic growth leads to growth in government revenues. It means if economic is increasing, the revenues are automatically increasing, and that will be reason to government to grow. The government uses this increased revenue in running various welfare program. It is because of the increasing revenue that India could afford Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Scheme and near universal public distribution system. So what is Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Guarantee Act 2005? Aim assuring employment to every rural household, minimum 100 days of assured employment in a year, 1/3 jobs are reserved for women. If an applicant is not provided employment within 15 days, he/she is entitled to a daily unemployment allowance. Wage as per the Minimum Wages Act. What is Prime Minister Rozgar Yojana? It is started in 1993. The aim to start this Yojana was to create self-employment opportunities for educated and unemployed youth in rural and small towns. Help in setting up small business and industries. What are the challenges? The challenges ahead and new approaches in poverty reduction. The Sustainable Development Goals of the United Nations calls for ending the extreme poverty by 2030. In this context, reduction of poverty requires innovative approaches in our country too. So further with development, it is expected that the definition of poverty will change. Though we have been able to maintain high economic growth in last 20 years, but this has not resulted in creating large number of employment. Further, we need to make anti-poverty schemes more effective. Following new approaches are worth mentioning here. They are Jan Dhan Yojana, Aadhaar and Mobile. It is also called JAM. This trinity could play an important role in widening the reach of the government to vulnerable sections. This would prevent the leakages in the distribution in the long run. Second one is universal basic income. It is considered as an alternative to various state subsidies for poverty alleviation economic survey. Though it is still at discussion level, the universal basic income envisages paying the beneficiaries directly into their bank account to help reduce leakage. So it was